The exile in Egypt, excerpt number 13.
Go ahead, please.
What is exile? It is that he is under the rule of self-love and cannot work for the sake of the Creator. When is self-love considered exile? It is only when he wants to emerge from this control because he suffers from not being able to do anything for the sake of the Creator.
That is, in order to bestow.
Excerpt number 14. We should know that the exile he feels, that he's in exile, is measured not by the exile, but by the sensation of bad and suffering that he suffers because he is in exile. Then, when he is tormented because he is under the rule of oppressors and he must do all that they demand of him, and he has no right to do what he wants, but he must serve and carry out all that the nations of the world in his body demand. And he is powerless to betray them. To the extent of the pain he feels and his desire to escape them, to that extent he can enjoy the redemption. Excerpt number 15, Rabash writes, as Baal Sulam explained, the exile in Egypt was in order to obtain the vessels of the Egyptians. But it was only to borrow and later to return to them. He interpreted that this matter of the Creator saying to Abraham, your descendants will be strangers in a land that is not theirs, was a guarantee of the inheritance. This means that they would have a need to receive the abundance from the Creator. Since wanting to come out of the enslavement of the Egyptians can be only through the help of a holy soul. Then they will need the Creator's help each time, and from this they will have a need to draw higher degrees.
Yeri says that the exile in Egypt was that the view of Kedusha was in exile. This means that the Klipa of Egypt ruled over the people of Israel. We should interpret that people of Israel means that the whole nation wanted to work for the sake of the Creator and not for their own sake. As it is known that Israel means Yashar El, Shakel, straight to the Creator, meaning everything for the Creator. The governance of Pharaoh is the opposite, to work only for one's own sake. For this reason, the view of Kedusha means that we must work for the sake of the Creator, meaning to bestow. This discernment was in exile under the rule of Pharaoh, king of Egypt, where Mitzrayim, Egypt, has the letters of Meitzar Yam, narrow sea, and it is known that narrow means scarce in Hasadim. Excerpt 17. When one properly sanctifies the point in the heart within him, he begins to enter the exile in Egypt. At that time, he begins to see each time how far he is from the act of bestow. Then, vessels form within him, meaning deficiencies, which the Creator will later be able to fill. 18. The benefit in the exile was the feeling that the will to receive is a sin. And this is the reason to decide that there is no other choice but to try to acquire vessels of bestow. This is the meaning of the Creator's answer to Abraham the patriarch about his request for guarantees for the inheritance of the land. Know for certain that your seed, etc., and they shall afflict them, etc. Through the exile, they would come to discover that the hair's breadth is a sin, and then they would accept the real work in order to detach themselves from the sin.
Excerpt number 19. In the state of lo lishma, a person feels that he is regarded as Israel. But when a person wants to begin the work of bestowal, meaning to have vessels to receive inner light, when he wants to emerge from self-love, then he comes into the exile in Egypt. That is, when a person sees how remote he is from adhesion, dvekut, with the Creator, in equivalence of form. Instead, whether in mind or in heart, the klipa of Egypt governs. In that state, he sees that he is far from being Israel. Instead, he is in a state of Jacob, a state of katnut, smallness, infancy, from the words akev, heel, and sof, end. In other words, he is in utter lowliness, seeing that each day he is farther from the Creator and has no grip on holiness. This is called the exile in Egypt.
We are in item 20.
Go ahead.
When the people of Israel were in exile in Egypt and were under the governance of Pharaoh, king of Mitzaryam, narrow sea, and wanted to emerge from his governance, they could not. It was still unclear to them what it means to work in order to bestow, and not for one's own sake. Although they wanted to work for the sake of the Creator, they saw that they couldn't. Yet, they always had excuses as to why they cannot aim in order to bestow, and they did not feel that they were so far from the Creator